You're fat. Oh, sorry.
Wrong folder.
More Chucky videos. Please, 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 please do another Chucky video. Please, Chucky boy. Do you have some news on the Child's Play remake? When you making a Chucky update? It's been pretty dry out there lately with the Chucky news, so there hasn't been anything that I can make a video on, but I hear your outcries, I hear your requests, and hey, you want a Chucky video? Chucky video is what you're gonna get. We are less than a month away. The trailer will drop around February 8th, so go ahead and save that date. I'm very excited for it. We'll finally get a whole ton of information, everything we really wanted to know that we've been speculating so far. So I thought, why not make one last speculation video before we get completely corrected in this trailer? I'm gonna go ahead and be breaking down the IMDb cast list, trying to figure out a little more of the plot points, breaking down some of these child actors that are gonna be part of this Child's Play remake, and also more behind the scene images provided by the Castlin Project. This is a Facebook group. If you wanna see any of the photos that I'm talking about, go ahead and join them on there. They haven't paid me or anything like that to say that. It's just where I've gotten a lot of my information, so I think it's only fair that I pay respects to that site. And if you haven't heard anything about this Child's Play remake, I do have a playlist for you on my channel, or a few videos in the description to get you up to date with that. This is a reimagining of the Child's Play movie back from 1988. They're taking away the voodoo. He's gonna be an AI robot, and it's gonna have a group of friends, much like Stranger Things or It. And with that said, it got me thinking, you know, there's been tons of movies out there where there's a group of kids that are the center of the focus of the movie. The Sandlot, The Goonies, It, Stranger Things, Stand By Me, and all of them have a recurring pattern in the kids that are in this movie. They all have the funny one, the mean one, the sensitive one, the hero one. So I thought, why not pinpoint to see who each one could be based off these behind the scene images before we get a hands down version of what they're going to be in this trailer. And I mean, it's not that hard to break down what these characters might be like, because Hollywood is very specific in the way they dress their characters to go with their personality. Now with this image right here, I'm not sure if this is exactly from the film or these are just the cast behind the scenes taking a fun little picture of them together. But right here you have Chris, Andy, Pug, Phelan, and Omar. If you look at Andy, who's the leader of this team, and judging from his previous incarnation, he's the innocent type. He's the good kid. And a khaki pants on a character is always an indication of the sweet, innocent character. And I mean, we see that here in this photo. Anytime camo is on a character, it also symbolizes strength or bravery. I mean, obviously to go intact with the military, but we see more than one character here is wearing camo in this movie. And could it be that his entire group is sort of strong and not afraid to fight this doll? Jumping on from there, let's go into the character of Pug. Now with a name like Pug, you know that's going to be quite an interesting character, but if you look at what he's wearing from these behind the scene images, it kind of gives me an idea of what this character is going to be like. Any character who wears these Hawaiian or floral pattern shirts is always the goofy one, the rude one, the one who's not afraid to do some of the weird and disgusting things in this movie. So he's most likely going to be the one pulling all the funny stuff, doing all the weird things. I mean, if you look at It in that remake, again, the kid who's wearing the floral pattern shirts in that movie is the funny, crude one. If you look at The Sandlot, again, a kid wearing that type of shirt is the funny, crude one. And lastly, with The Goonies, I mean, if you're up to showing your belly and doing whatever it is that kid was doing, you're the funny and crude one. So I don't think it'll be that different with this character. And in this behind the scene image, we even see he has a little bit of blood on him. So I think he's actually gonna go mano a mano with this new Chucky. And from there, we have the character of Chris. Now, anyone who's gonna be a Chris in this movie like me, you know they're gonna be a good character. But one thing's for sure, they're going with a very diverse group of characters in this movie, just cause it's, you know, 21st century, everybody's gotta be included. The next character we have here is Phelan, and lately with all these group of friend kids, there's always a female in the group. And the female character in these movies is usually a character who can hang with the guys. And judging from her outfit, she's most likely gonna be some sort of tomboy that's not afraid to burp or do other things around these guys. Heck, she could even be the bully. And then jumping off to the character of Omar, it's rumored that he actually might be the son of Detective Norris in this movie, and that's why he's put on the case to help the Barkley family since they are close to each other. But I just think that's people putting two characters of the same race together and saying they're probably related, which I don't think will be the case. So that looks like it's gonna be the friends, and that's really all I can assume from this image of them. But if I had to pick one of these people to die, I hate to say it, but I think it might be Chris. I feel like he might be the one to go, but then again, it's very doubtful that they might even kill any of these kids if they're trying to start a franchise, because you don't want to keep losing your group of friends in this movie. But it's also worth noting, they're not the only kids in this cast list that might have a big part in this film. Some other things here that IMDb puts on their list is they have here a character named Ben. And I don't know, just looking at that face, you know that's the type of kid that probably bullies other kids. So he might be an enemy of the group. Each of these groups always has some sort of enemy throughout their movie that either bites the dust towards the end or joins forces with the evil being to go after this group of friends. So I think that's what Ben might be from this cast listing. And we already know Aubrey Plaza and Brian Tyree Henry are going to be playing the mother and detective roles, and there's not much to be expected there. I'm sure the characters will be pretty faithful or in line of what you would think from the previous incarnation of Chucky. Another interesting thing to see here in the IMDb page is there is a lot of blank customers. You have here disappointed customer, frustrated customer, angry customer. Now this leads me to two theories with these group of customers. One, I'm thinking this Buddy doll is so high in demand that it's been sold out. Sort of like a Jingle All the Way scenario where moms are really trying to get this present for their kid, because this movie is taking place around the holiday season, Christmas time, so people are really trying to buy this doll, and we're probably going to get a scene of angry customers going, where's this doll? I want to see this doll. I want to have this doll. And if it's not that, my other theory on that is Chucky went ahead and is fulfilling his army, and they're having a bunch of defective dolls that are affecting their home life, and now they're coming into the store to complain or return them. And one of the last interesting characters we have here on the IMDb page is a homeless man. Now, if you're familiar with the original Child's Play, you know there's only one role for a homeless man, and that's to give the doll to Karen, the mom. It'll be interesting to know how this homeless man got his hands on the doll, because in the original movie, it was from a broken down store, he just looted it and then sold it off the street. From my understanding, this is a doll that's going to be created in a foreign country when a factory worker goes ahead and commits suicide. So that doll's eventually got to get from this country to our country, and how does it end up in the hands of a homeless man? Or I mean, they could have a completely different role for this homeless man, but I'm just assuming that they'll go ahead and do the traditional way of homeless man meets Karen, Karen gets doll, Karen gives doll to Andy. As far as some other behind the scene images here to further help us with speculation, a house out in the country or farmland, which I thought was very interesting because this movie is supposed to be taking place in Chicago, and that's a very urban place with a very city-like feel. But then again, if you look at these other behind the scene images, you get of what definitely looks like farmland, and if you zoom in right here, you get to see a little killer doll standing there waiting for his prey. Which, I mean, honestly, that photo alone just looks interesting as hell to me. And can you imagine being out in the middle of nowhere and this doll is chasing you? So it'll be interesting to know what that house is going to be used for or who's living there. But anyways, that's just what I could speculate from these images and from the casting list. There's not much to go off anymore. I'm still waiting for more news to come out. And with the trailer coming out soon, we're going to get a poster. We're probably going to get a full look at Chucky. What are some things that you want to see in this trailer? For one, I definitely want to see a full shot of Chucky. I want to see exactly what he looks like, not just half face. I also want to get a good understanding of these kids and what their character backgrounds might be like, and seeing if they have good chemistry together and if they're going to be as fun as some of the other kids we've gotten in horror movies. But at the same time, not too much, because I do want to go into this movie surprised and happy. So don't give me the whole movie in this trailer. Anyways, guys, with these behind the scenes images and the cast listing, are there any theories you can throw out there? Any speculation you might could think of? Anything that you think I'm wrong with? Go ahead and let me know down below. Always happy to share with you guys. Be sure to like and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter @3CFilmReview. As always, I'm Chris. Take care.